All right, so start this. Oh, son of a bitch. There we go. Got audio. We're basically gonna start this by having a mass exodus of the park so that it'll clear up a little bit of frame rate. As you can see, we still have 4,000 people. There were over 6,000 to start. That's a lot of people. That's a lot of people. And so you're just gonna see this mass exodus of all these people just trying to get the hell out of the park. Through one entrance. And exiting into this cave of basically black darkness. It looks like we're starting to get some of the stragglers out. There's still people riding the rides because if they were in the line, they get to ride the ride and finish out their ride. You have Cowman over here just freaking out, bouncing around, having a good old time. And what appears to be a giant udder. Utter madness. We are just losing money left and right. So we're actually going to slow it down and actually go through this park before we lose all of our money. So, this is Jack-O-Land. Why it's called Jack-O-Land? No real idea. Nobody really knows. That's just how it is, and that's just how it was. So, you come into this beautiful little scenery. You see some shit over there. Clearly some incredible roller coasters. You get to see the little vignettes. They come up, vignette, and I'm gonna say vignette. I know it's vignette. I just like saying vignette. Or whatever the hell. Speak English around here, not French. So you have this beautiful tree-lined area into this giant mountain. You look right, you look left, you have all these trees, you see coasters and stuff going over there. And then you walk in, double pirates. And bam. Nice sculpture. Nice little house. It's information. It's not actually information, but we decided not to put in all those special little side route things. So you take a ride, and remember, this park was never actually really finished, so you'll bear with me for some things. So you have a bathroom there. You have a swing arm ride there. You have a chief beef. Remember, each one of these is, you know, individual pieces. Bam. That's a piece, that's a piece, that's a piece. That's a piece, these are pieces, those are pieces. Everything's its own individual piece. This Planet Coaster is awesome like that. That's fine. You get in your first line. Go behind the Chief Beef. Again, a teacup ride. Now, we're not gonna sit and go on all the rides, but you get this little teacup ride, you know, a little something for the kiddie boos. Come back out again, buy some hats. Now everything was finished. You have a plane ride where you swoop around in planes. A nice little area. Yeah, we have the fast pass, but yeah, we kind of canceled that program. We have a Cosmic Cow milkshake. Remember, everything here is pirate-themed, even the entertainers. Pirate-themed. Now you come over here to the first real ride. Just Goshi's Revenge. Nice trek through the firelit pathway. Brings you up to the little outdoor shack. For Goshi's Revenge. We're gonna hop on Goshi's Revenge right now. Now, full disclosure, I did not build this roller coaster, but I did design all the scenery around it. All the trees, everything. Goshi's Revenge. Nothing too crazy. Got a smoky lake down here to give you a view of some of the scenery. Got trees. Okay, we're gonna stop that. We're gonna set it to 10 a.m. This is a nice little scenic roller coaster. Not too complicated, but lots of thrills. You have some lights on for nighttime. You're gonna give it a little watch from the outside perspective. Lots of tunnels, lots of things going on. Lots of excitement. Always stuff to see, really engaging. Gotta get you engaged. So after Goshi's Revenge, you come out. And you're right here by the ATMs. And we're just gonna... We're gonna put that into test mode. So this was our little scenic ride car. We're gonna go catch... Wasn't too crazy. Just like I said, little ride for the kiddies, you know? Something to keep them entertained, a little PG fun. Going through the mountain. This was always something I wanted to finish working on, but never really had the time or the effort to. Supposed to be a little trek through the jungle, see some crashed pirate ships. Like, what the hell's a pirate ship doing there? Was this place once underwater? Well, it may have been. Just gonna speed this up a little, because we don't need to sit here forever. Aw, yeah. Gives you a little, just a little scenic tour of the park. See some pirates fighting. Oh shit, they're shooting at ya. Terrifying. Don't want pirates shooting at you. Get to see some of the ships, some of the swinging ship ride that's over there, out on the little water. See some of the other rides, some of the roller coasters up there. Nice, nice. All it's time to get back at the pirates, shoot them in the back because they're still hiding there. Pow, pow. Two dead pirates. Go by this little pirate camp. Clearly that's what they were defending. Defending the pirate camp. Now you have some rock facades on the other side, but more importantly you have a little pirate camp over here. Dude's defending that shiz. Cause you gotta defend the pirate camp. He even come out and pop you one. Hiding down there. Behind the rock. Popping you one. Going to the Flaming Skull. Pretend that goes off right before it charges you to a nice burn. You know, we're gonna pretend that we're not getting burned by the skulls there. You know, hopefully do well. Hopefully do some good by it. Reach out, touch Faith. The name of the ship is Faith. I'm gonna keep going. I'm gonna speed up this drive as we bring it around. Like I said, it's something we meant to finish but never really got around to it. People seemed to like it, so we just ran with it. Alright. Moving right along. Then if you would have fought now, said we had some weird pathing stuff. Don't know. It's not really pirate themed, I guess more western themed, but we don't really have a pirate, so that's the best we're gonna do. They had this little village over here, you know. Some sodas, the bathroom area, got your hot dog squad, security man patrol and everything. Got water. Got music to keep it all nice and promenade. And this starts probably one of our better roller coasters. So this starts that bad boy, Xelox Cove. Xelox Cove, you say? Yes, Xelox Cove. And in we go. We travel through the nice. I don't know how that got that color, but let's keep going. All the scenery, you get to see the coaster flying past you there. All the trees make it nice and pretty. And we arrive at Xelox Cove. We just had a train leave. Now we're gonna test this. Whoa. Here. I'm gonna go sit in the middle. Now that would be the cannon fire above going off. Speed it up till it's our turn. Now this was a three. Okay, there we go. And out we go. Right under the pathway. And your initial first loop and lift it. I really like that. It builds some excitement right at the beginning. You can see, hello, fellow, you know, crash test dummies. You climb up. I don't know if it's necessarily a cove so much as a Xelox Mountain, but Xelox Cove has had a better ring to it than Xelox Mountain, so we went with Xelox Cove. Now we're going to wait here because my timing is not perfect. I thought I had this figured out. I really did. Turns out I don't, and you end up just sitting here looking around like, what the hell is going on? Did this ride break? Well, no, this ride didn't break. It was just poorly designed, and here we go. A little upside down action. A little more upside down action. Sideways action. Finally turning you right side up. Knowing you for that zero G roll. Saying hi to the trees. Elongated roll, saying hi to more trees. Taking you right into the station. And that's how Xelox Cove worked. I was actually really happy with it when I made it. Came out really nice. Very, very proud of it. Alright. So let's say you didn't go into Xelox Cove and you took a hard left. Went all along up here. There's some nice shops. Wanted to do something here, but I just never got around to it. Then you have two options. You have the zero-G spinning thinger in there, which we're not going to explore. It's the basic pirate building. We had our pirate shops. That's more of the emergency room. Got him excelente. Pip shot. And this pip shot had so many rocks you can't actually get to it. Did not notice that. Then you had this ride, which is called Rip Curl, which is how you know I did not make it. But we're going to take a ride on it anyway. This was one of the lesser scenery. This was more I needed a roller coaster in this area of the park, so we made a roller coaster in this area of the park. That's simple. Sometimes it's what's his name's razor. I don't know if that's the appropriate one. Sometimes the simplest definition is the best. Oh yeah, it is the razor. Sometimes the simplest definition is the best definition, which is what we have here. Like I said, this one wasn't very scenic. This was more just to put a roller coaster here. I tried building one of these types of roller coasters during the Empire Wide. Absolute garbage. So I let the game do it for me. And it made this coaster. Say about this, it's not my coaster, I didn't design it, can't tell you what went into it. So moving right along this outer path, we started to build something there to go to this ride, and we have a nice little pirate village over here. You have the Ferris wheel, which, you know, you have some nice shrubberies. Little fountain, little puffer fish, little waterfall action, little jet spray action going on to your big wheel over there. And we made a little pirate village. You know, some of these buildings came pre-built. Some of these things we built. This was to be one of our more enticing roller coasters. So it was called Treasure Island. Pirates all around, watching, looking out. You got doors on doors. Got a little pirate village over here. You had the Chief Beef. You could go through. You had the Cosmic Cow. A little scenic area. You had some gourmet coffee in an instant because you had some Fox Bros coffee. So you came in this line, which, you know, you come down here. Oh, how beautiful. Very scenic. You go by the buildings. You're like, okay, I'm in a little pirate town. Okay, things get a little shanty. Got dudes sitting here with just some cannonballs. And, you know, this line went on forever because this was supposed to be a big roller coaster. And that's what big roller coasters do. So, we're going to sit here. We're going to test this. We're going to get on that first cart. Train number one. We're going to go seat number one or seat number two. And this is something we designed. It was supposed to be thematic, as you can see in the corner over here. We have the Kraken coming up terrorizing the ship. How very scary. It's okay, you know. You can pop over there, see a bit more of the Kraken, shooting water, scaring all the people on the ship. We're going to go back in the middle seat as we climb this giant lift hill. Now this is a suspended roller coaster, so if you would look down, you would just see your feet dangling there, you know? Kinda nice, gives you a little free air sensation. Of course, it's a suspended roller coaster, meaning that, you know, the rail's on top of you because, like I said, your feet are on the bottom. Just hanging there. Not the only type of roller coaster that runs with hanging feet. There are bottom-railed roller coasters that hang with feet. And here we go. We're heading to the cliff. But up we go, throwing us around upside down, taking you upside down, down a hill. that was a very novel effect. Something you don't see very often would scare the living bejesus out of this meeting. You go on one loop. Come into a nice horseshoe bend. There was going to be Treasure Island. We come down, do a little zero-g barrel roll. Do another zero-g roll. Come into a bowtie horseshoe. To all around. That would have been Treasure Island. I'm going to do a couple barrel rolls there. And that's going to be it. It was a very fast, in-your-face coaster. Lots of excitement, lots of entertainment. Stuff to look at while you're all around. There's going to be more stuff here, as you can imagine. There's the dude trying to escape, shooting the Kraken. I don't know what one bullet's going to do on the Kraken, because as you can see, there's clearly a bunch of stuff going down. Dude's trying to shoot the Kraken, but yeah, that ain't going to help. Kraken's already got you, boy. Then if you keep coming, you're going to run to a little Chief Beef Shack, some toilets, a little scene between the pirates and the colonials there. You had a back alley under area, which we were going to develop up into some stores and a bathroom. And that came out right here, which to the, we're going to drag you up, take a nice circular view of the park, drop you down. The whole point was to lead you to this roller coaster. Which, if we're going to get in the line for, come out. There's a nice lake over there. Come out, little pirate area. You know, dude's just chilling. Enjoying the fire. Little shrubberies. Come in here. Go through this whole line. Trying not to get shot by the angry pirate, protecting his booty. The booty! Come over here into this little shanty shack. Alright, then this was our hyper coaster, and the whole point of hyper coasters is they're supposed to go fast. So as you can see, this one gets vertical very quickly, pulling you up at nearly 90 degrees. It's kind of scary. It's quite a lift hill. Well, we wanted to get you very high and not a lot of distance because we wanted to make people go fast. Because if you're not first, you're last. And if you're not first, and if you're not fast, you're not first. So we wanted to make you go first by going fast. So first and fast. And that's what we're going to do here. So it takes you right up to the edge and then says goodnight. Fun rating of almost 7. almost 7. This big bad boy up here. So just to let you know, that's the downward spot, like, you take. Like, it may have seemed a high climb, and you might have gone down fast, but take some stuff on that. The highest speed you got is 83 miles per hour, which ain't too shabby for a roller coaster. Then looped you around, a couple more. Looped you around, one more, and then there you go. If you were to keep following this backwards trail, you would have gone to this, which was nothing. You would have come around and see we have a little shop corner. I did not build that shop corner. And then you'd reconnect to the rest of the park that if you had gone around and taken the right to Xelox Cove, you would A, see this nice scenic area of a Mexalente with a bunch of barrels and a very aggressive restroom. Another scenic picture spot to take while Xelox Cove would be flying by. Go into this underground area, some nice signage, a gulpy milkshake or whatever the hell it was. Come out here. You have some pirates taking a battle over there. Lots of pirates shooting. Also, you know, nothing there. Actually, no, this was actually something. There is a first aid station there, believe it or not. And we disguised it. Then you would come out here, go on the sea ride. Lots of water spraying everywhere. This dude's boat clearly has sprung a leak. It's not good for him. Now, there are a couple options. You could go this way, another bathroom, because apparently people just need bathrooms in this game. We got a nice coffee shop that we designed. Cannons firing out everywhere. I think they coincide to splashes in the water. Yup. A nice little scenic vignettes. A little scenic route to the kickflip. What the masterpiece was you took this road back here into Bales Lagoon. Very shanty-esque. Balef clearly was a pirate, putting on a pirate show. These guys are sitting here watching the pirate show. Pirate in a barrel. Aww, did they go out of power? Yeah, it looks like they lost. Oh, nope. And there they go. She's puffing on what I can only assume is some reefer, because they're pirates after all. And then you come into Balef's Lagoon. Bunch of pirates waiting to send you off. So we're gonna do just that. Send us off proper, boys! One of my more scenic roller coasters, your lift hill takes you through a bunch of ship's interiors. As you can see, there's lights everywhere. This is meant to also be seen at night. The park is open at night, ladies and gentlemen. You entertain people throughout the day. It's part of the joy, it's part of the fun. And right back into the station. How lovely. This also almost got us a 7. So some of the things you could see, you would have 3 cannons here firing at that poor little boat. Dude made off with some booty, and now he's stuck on the ocean, so yeah, he not in for a good time. Bailiff's Lagoon over here, Bailiff over there, showing up against the railing, getting nice little views. That was Bailiff's Lagoon. Come over here, you still got some people making the way out town. Yeah, a lot of these little scenery things, and it's one of those things you couldn't make it too big, well, because you had the pirates fighting off against the colonials. Damn colonials. And then you came over here, we had some nice scenery areas. We had go-karts. Proper, festive themes. You gotta have your protective rails, cause, you know, still people on that ride. You gotta have your festive rails, because you don't want any cars flying off and hitting the nice people. This is a very scenic area. You had your statues, you had all your foliage. You had places you could go in and check out. Just hang, chill, go to the toilet. See, this guy got it right. He just chilling there. Come around here, all the nice scenery. Dude's just hanging out, having a good time, enjoying the pirate life. One of my favorite scenes was this right here. And then you bring it down. I think this is a very pretty scene. You see the roller coaster going on in the background. You'd see the carts and everything, and yeah, you see some of the aircon units back there, but let's be honest here, you know, this is a theme park, these are buildings, you need things to work. But I just like this scene, you know, you had the mermaid lady there, and you know, you had all your stuff going, and many guests are hungry. Well, good for them, because there's not many guests, period. And I was actually really happy with this. It worked out. Things seem nice. Things seem to be going the right way. And, well, we just got too big for our britches and, well, started to lag our system out. As you can see, we had a lot of pirate scenic area. And the chief beef over here, we had a Mansoor Freet. Don't steal his booty either. He came down here now. We had this roller coaster. This is another one of those basic roller coasters. I just imported it from the game. But we made it kind of look like it's going into the rocks. A little scary, a little nerve-wracking. We put a cosmic cow right underneath. Because, like I said, one of the themes of my park that I really like putting in my park is the integration of rides into the walkway. We put every one of these fucking rocks here to create this kind of stony border to build up and hide some of the vertical of the ride. Now this whole area, as you can see here by the overall view of my park, there's clear areas. You have a back area here, this area over here, you have your main area, you have your right area, and you have this kind of area. So we've explored most of the areas, gone through, seen a lot of the things there are to be seen. One of the last parts was if you had taken a right off the entrance, you would have walked by all this lovely scenery. Low frame rate. You would have seen the little scenic alcove for picture taken with Captain Lockjaw himself. For all the people. There's still 20 of them in my park somehow. Just the memento. Fed the octopus ride. Scenic areas, pizza pen, some energy, an ATM. But you would have gone to take a ride on this bad boy here. Gonna go through the whole path. And all this was custom designed, you know, this was a pain in the ass to do, not gonna lie. This chain, pain in the ass to do. Gotta line up a lot of things. Roller coaster would come overhead, but this is called escape velocity. And we designed this ourselves. So we're gonna test it. Throw us into train two. And then, oh god. Oh god, we're gonna hit that door. We're gonna hit that door. Nope. Up to volcano. Upside down and sideways. I don't know what it is. I like putting people sideways, as you see there. That falls in. Certainly wants to do like being doing so. I wanted to give you a little chance to experience that sideways action. Escape velocity, and then brings you back into the row of trees. Heartbreaking. And then you would walk out here and come out into the underway. At which point you could either go back to where the swinging ship was, walk all the way up here, get into this area. We're gonna take you on the last little piece of this park. If you went under here, we had a subterranean era. So we had a whole era of subterranean down here. I like the way this looked. You had this nice blue glow for all the stores. And you could get on this here ride right here. Start out with the nice florals. You know, parrot saying, come on this way. Go up here. Go by all the trees. At which point you would get on the log flume. I'm gonna speed up parts of this because, let's be honest, nobody wants to sit here for 20 minutes and do a log flume. People really like this. Down in the cove. That was guaranteed to get you soaked. Because if you saw how much water that thing puts up. It was all in a cave, which means it's hitting the ceiling and coming back right down on you. Now, don't worry, ladies and gentlemen. Our ceilings are 100% covered and protected. You know, you're not getting no mossy, germy water on you. They do have a clear plastic coating on them, which we wash and scrub regularly. Just letting you know, little cave trekking. Exploring the mountainous regions. Enjoying your time and your scenery. We're gonna look at the final drop into the big wave pool. And yes, you did just get very, very wet there. And then we came around. And that would be the end. And that was Jack-O-Land. A glorious bunch of work and effort to make a pirate-themed theme park. I think we did a pretty good job. I think it turned out really nicely. It eventually got to the point where my computer could no longer handle it. Oh, by the way, here was the racetrack. You started out. You literally would drive under the roller coaster. If you were lucky, you'd have people screaming out going over you. Come around, do a little turn around the lake, under the mountain, little hairpin turns, and back in the station. And this was my park. I was actually kind of proud of it. I thought it was very well built, very well done, very well designed. And that's what I'm going to leave you with. And enjoy the park. Because it was really pretty and a lot of work. Y'all have a good night.